Opkai kala ma kahikina me kahua ihele no kumukai amaina iva me iaka me kapola kai ka ulu vei vei ne emaina iva ma kualo me ke alo kapua ke iva iva o ie ke kapu me nali e ola ma kua paulo ala e ala e ala e
We have invited you all here to witness the cultivation of a new era of PIDP, a new era in engagement in Hawaii and the United States, amongst the 18 Pacific Islands Forum members and across the entire Blue Pacific community. The Pacific region has changed remarkably in the 40-odd years since PIDP was established at the East-West Center, and PIDP is changing with it. Today, we were privileged to listen and hear the views of Pacific leaders as we asked how we should chart PIDP's new course into the next 40 years. We focused on what it means to be connected, emphasizing the need for continuous consultation and innovation, and recognizing that celebrating our special connectedness with this place, Hawaii, and the freely associated states is critical for rebuilding connections with the Pacific region as a whole. Finally, we focus on what it means to be relevant, which means owning our place in the regional architecture and living up to the hyphen in the East-West Center by bridging the Pacific Islands and the continental U.S.
The United States is committed to our Pacific allies and partners in promoting a free and open Indo-Pacific, and we are committed to the Pacific Islands' future security and prosperity. At the heart of our approach in the Indo-Pacific, we believe that allies and partners are critical to the prosperity and security of the region. And importantly, that all countries, large and small, in the Indo-Pacific should have a voice in shaping that international system. And despite the cultural differences across the region, I think there are three common areas which make up the foundation of our partnership efforts, particularly with the Pacific Island nations. And these are our values, our interests, and our mutual security concerns. These common areas have been at the heart of the United States' approach to the Indo-Pacific throughout our history, and we remain committed to these tenets. Our ties with the freely associated states stretch back to our shared heritage as seafaring nations and the bonds we forged during World War II. These bonds intertwine and will extend well into the future.
And on behalf of the First Lady, our delegation from the Federated States of Micronesia express our profound appreciation to the East-West Center and the PIDP for the opportunity to engage leaders in a diverse setting like this. A free and open Indo-Pacific can seem simple, but it's more complicated than keeping sea lanes open and promoting democracy. It's complex, not in spite of its simple aims, but because of them. This should compel us to reconsider our views and accept the complexity of the issues and challenges confronting the countries in this region. In a bigger scheme of things, the Pacific Island countries continue to grapple with the issues of regional security and stability, economic prosperity and development, and the challenge of ensuring that the principle, as you have mentioned, Admiral, good governance prevails in our decision-making process throughout the Pacific Island countries. The FSM, Palau, and RMI combined are larger than the United States, believe it or not, and that's why recently, even at the United Nations, I think we've always been using the acronym as small island states, but now we realize that our ocean being big, you know, we call ourselves right now as a big ocean state. Isn't that a better way to put it? The Pacific Islands Development Program, if I may turn to that, because today, as you have convened a very productive meeting here at the East-West Center, we're proud of the role that East-West Center have played and the Pacific Islands Development Program in the leadership program that has developed our human resources and therefore has helped the nation building process that our country has been going through. And so the Pacific Islands Development Program has been a platform to discuss critical issues for nearly 40 years. So ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you that the Pacific Islands program is a regional organization that historically has added tremendous value to regional empowerment and development. The FAS countries are proud of this relationship, this partnership with you, East West Center and PIDP and Admiral. We are very proud of our relationship with the United States. Thank you so much, and we say kalangan in the spirit of our language. Thank you so much for the opportunity to say a few words.